good seeing everyone. Probably haven't seen you all since I was like six, maybe. Hi, thank you for coming. I've thought about this for about a year and a half, and I've thought about what I wanted to say, trying to sound like an adult or professional, and fully forgetting who this was for. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Jerry Granelli's first grandchild, meaning he loved me the most. Luca even knows it to be true. And what that does mean is I had the privilege of getting to know him for 21 years of my life. My grandfather was known for his success as a drummer in Charlie Brown Christmas and the Vince Guaraldi Trio, as well as the psychedelic rock band Light Sound of Dimension. And although he would never let us live that down, I knew my grandfather for being a human. Sorry, where am I? To me, my grandfather was messy. He was kind-hearted. He was sometimes cocky, and he was completely empathetic. He was the best teacher that you will ever meet. And my grandfather, yes, was a terrific drum teacher and mentor, but he was more than that. My grandfather taught me that everyone was a team player, and that no matter who you were, everyone was important. My grandfather taught me how to humanize pain, and he told me that no matter what I was feeling, it wasn't always black and white. He taught me that being a human being is messy, as well as beautiful, scary, and incredibly fun. I'll leave you with a short story. My grandfather once came up to visit me at school. We were shooting the shit, as we usually did. And he says to me, "You know, you're almost a human being." And I was 17, thinking I was 35, so I didn't get it. But I do now. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank my grandfather for allowing the world to see him as a human, not just his creative side or his fun side, but the parts of ourselves that we are conditioned to hide. Thank you guys so much for coming out. I hope you enjoyed the show.
That was my kid. Thank you so much for all being here tonight. I think I literally know every person in the audience, which is like an amazing thing. But if you don't know me, I'm Jay. Jerry was my dad, and we're gonna, with the help of some really amazing, amazing musicians and some of my dearest friends, play a bunch of my dad's music for you tonight. Some of it, it's not all necessarily his, but the stuff that isn't his, he loved to play, and it reminds me of him. The cast up here will kind of change as we go, and I'll announce who everybody is as we reconfigure for you. The first piece is going to be myself and Suzanne Choi, who's around here somewhere, over there, and my wife Lana and Lola, our daughter, are also going to play some stuff. So anyway, this is called Bells for Him and Doug. It's not Bells for Him and Doug, it's Bells for Him. But Doug is playing. Okay, so we're going to continue on with an Ornette Coleman composition entitled Blues Connotation. You're going to hear this song a couple of different ways tonight, actually. It was a big favorite of my father's. So we're going to invite like a whole army of people up here. Brad Shepik on guitar. Mike Serene on drums. Mr. Peter Epstein on alto saxophone. Brigham Kraus on alto saxophone. Arnold Hammerschlag on trumpet. Mr. Michael Blake on tenor saxophone. And Jane Ira Bloom on soprano saxophone.
All right.
Hello. So that was fun. we're gonna play a composition of my dad's now, entitled "Coming Through Slaughter." No, we totally rehearsed this. Thank you.
Michael Blake.
Mike Serene. So we're here celebrating my dad, and he was my dad. and he was also this amazing musician and also a person. If there is such a thing in my life as my musical mom, this next person is she. And she also is an amazing musician and an amazing person. And she's one of my favorite people. So please welcome Jay Clayton to the stage.
Jay, my little Jay, yeah, how sweet. Well, I usually preface my long speeches by saying I'm not going to talk very much, and I won't much, but I do have to say some things about the great Jerry Granelli. Some of you know, I just want to give you a brief little, maybe you know, maybe you don't, how we met. I mean, we met because I did Boulder, Colorado, Colin Walcott and the whole group Oregon had a wonderful workshop up. You all probably know about Naropa. But anyway, I finally got invited out to do, and I was so happy. But I had never met Jerry, and so I just want to say that after the very first faculty meeting, after the meeting, I'm telling you, I never met him. He said, "Jay, you want to do a concert in a couple of weeks?" So she. Sure, I mean, I could say no. I mean, with me and Colin Walcott. Okay, two percussionists, that's it. And the rest is history. But how wonderful. And I'm telling you that from then on, we are spiritual, soulful musicians. And of course, we all miss him. But I'm telling you, we did duets. I used to go to his house in the basement. You know, our kids were little. My little Deja, who's now not so little, was there, and you guys. And we just played, period. End of story. Just played. How wonderful. Of course, I came out of the 60s, so that's no mystery. But anyway, we did some duets. So I will do, and later on, it was mostly free, and then I think the first poem I will do. I'm just going to do some duets, but I really would like to invite Judy Nemec, if you don't mind, for a short. Judy has an a cappella thing she would like to, and she was in Berlin teaching with Jerry for many years, so you're going to represent the Berlin contingent, who would all be here if they could, I'm sure. So if you could do your thing, and then I'll do my little thing.
Thank you. Thank you, Jay. One of my teachers. Jay Clayton. And Jerry was another one, so lucky to have lived near him and taught alongside him in Berlin and watched him inspire so many generations there. This is by Joy Harjo, and it's a prayer. It's called Eagle Poem. To pray. You open your whole self to sky, to earth, to sun, to moon, to one whole self that is you. And know there is more that you can't see, can't hear, can't touch, except in moments steadily growing, or in languages that aren't always sound, but other circles in motion, like eagle that Sunday morning down by Salt River, circled in blue sky and wind, swept our hearts clean on sacred wings. We see you, we see ourselves, and we know that we must take the utmost care and kindness in all things. Breathe in, knowing we are made of all this, and breathe, knowing we are truly blessed, because we were born and die soon within a true circle of motion, like eagle rounding out the morning inside us. We pray that it will be done in beauty, in beauty, in beauty.
Judy Niemack.
Beautiful. Love that. Beautiful.
Anyway, in a perfect world, I would do a duet with everybody, and actually probably in this whole room, but I've chosen a couple, okay? So why don't we start, okay? Emily Dickinson said, and this, I think this is the first one I recorded with Granelli. He called me Clayton, you know. I had a hard time coming today, you know, but I kept, you know, hearing him say, "Clayton, get your butt over there." So here I am, and I feel wonderful because look at the people here. Okay, Emily Dickinson said, "I'm nobody. Who are you? Are you nobody too?" Then there are a pair of us. Then there are a pair of us. Banish us, you know. They banish us, you know. How dreary to be somebody. How public, like a frog. How public, like a frog. To tell your name livelong day. To an admiring bog. Jay! Thank you, thank you. Now, where did she go? Jane Ira, I mean. Well, anyway, we had a trio, but that's what I got. Look at these guys. Okay, look at these guys. So, I love it. I love all of them. So, I meant we were going to do duets, but, you know, subject to change. Or not, improvisation. That's my next improv book. It's going to be called Or Not. So, come on, you guys. Let's do another one, okay? And then I'll do another one, and that'll be it. Okay. So, I think I wrote this one. And I think it's appropriate. I say I think because you know how sometimes everybody does. I listen to music and words come and I write them, but I don't have that many. But I think I did this one. Why do people come and go? Why do people come and go? And then, why now? Why when? And then there are those who stay and stay and stay and stay and stay. And stay even when they go. So I'll do one more with everybody. I'll tell you why. How about, do you remember, I think it was in Halifax, must have been. I'll never forget that, of course, there was a big concert, such a big, there's thousands of us up here, and we just played free. Remember? That's Granelli. So I'm telling you, and as much as he taught me to be crazy, because I was already crazy and I already was into this, he really taught me about space. And for those of, I know there's some singers know, I even in my improv teaching, I have a 12-step program. If you're interested, call me later. But the first step is space. Let's start, man, Banks said, waste not time in backward looks. Waste not time in backward looks. Let go. Let go. Move on. Face full to the wind. Face full to the wind. The mind cleansed of no's and not's. The mind cleansed of no's and not's. The heart accepting of yeses, yeses and can be's. But away. The heart accepting of yeses and can be's. In charity, and new beginnings.
Thank you, guys.
Holy cow. That is what you call the real deal.
My microphone is not the real deal.
Okay, so we're gonna welcome back to the stage. Well, no. First, we're gonna welcome to the stage Mr. Aaron Alexander. Where's Aaron Alexander? I met Aaron. Am I? Oh, shoot. I'm skipping a tune. Never mind. We're going to, Owen Howard is going to come up. And Arnold Hammerschlag is going to come back. And Brigham Krause on alto saxophone. This composition is entitled Berlin Sky, and it's one of my father's. Okay, so now I am where I thought I was a second ago. Again. So we are going to bring up to the stage Mr. Aaron Alexander. I have to tell you this super quick story. The summer before my senior year of high school, I moved to Seattle to live with my dad. And I didn't know anybody, and he said, I've got this student, this guy Aaron Alexander, he's a drummer. You'll really like him. You guys should get together. Somehow we got in touch with each other, and we went to a punk rock riot. And I was like, this is the best city ever. And so we're going to play now. This is another composition of my dad's entitled The Wheel. Thank you. Epstein, Brigham Krause, Brad Shevick, Mr. Aaron Alexander, Michael Blake, Arnold Hammerschlag. Holy cow. We're going to take a short break, short break. So please, nobody move. Short break, and then we'll be right back. Rindy Eckert's going to be here. So many more people. Bob Lindsay. It's going to be great. Short break. Hello.
Hello.
Oh. Hi. Who? Hi, Pete. Is Kara there? Hi, Kara.
This is from a piece called Sandhills Reunion. It's a suite of pieces that Jerry put together, and I wrote all the text for it. It was kind of an accident. It's a long story, but it seems that, you know, Jerry was great with accidents. You know, he caused some of the most amazing accidents in his life. And this is one of them.
Retrieving a drummer.
Oh.
The place is lousy with drummers, except the one we need.
Oh, okay.
So you got any patter? Or?
No. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound. That saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found. Was blind, but now I see. Rained last night in the sand hills, northwest of Broken Bow. It's been that kind of season, and the grass knows it, high as a horse. Imagine Billy the Kid on a dappled mare, tipping his hat, gliding like a ghost in the blue stem and Indian grass. His horse invisible under him. Of course, he never got this far north. Good thing, too. Nowhere to hide in this country. Would have had to ride for days without rest, or find a gullible rancher would cover for him, or a girl wouldn't mind company, even bad news like Billy. Welcome. In the sand hills, her skirts rustling like prairie grass under the cottonwoods. Not enough. another soul around. Posse caught in a downpour about 10 miles off. And a lonely gal with a desperado in the grass. Turns in her sleep, while in my mind's eye, Billy gets up, smells the rain coming, says something nice to the woman, polite, excuses himself to glide like a ghost in the tall prairie grass. Catch up to me soon, he thinks. The grass will drink it up. Didn't ask her her name. Nothing happens, wasn't meant to be. Nothing happens, wasn't meant to be. Puddles in the gravel drive, and I rise to shut the window. The dog gives me a look, then settles again, resting his head on his paws. Not unwelcome, the rain. Not unwelcome at all. Like a friend staying up with me to say, it's all right. Nothing happens. Wasn't meant to be. Kid makes it out of the territory, finds some lost herd, follows the trampled grass till he sees them, and gallops in, hollering for all he's worth, arms flailing like some crazed turkey, scattering them so they make a dozen tracks. A confusion for the posse, not knowing which way he took. He finds his way south, back in the real story, where fate can deal with him as it planned all along.
Randy Eckert, holy cow. Michael Blake, Peter Epstein. Okay, so this song is called The Swamp, although it's one of my father's, and it was also called The Oyster Dance once. It is like a some kind of horrific baptism by fire that many of his students over the years have been, hey, why don't we play this? And he puts it in front of you. So anyway, it's called The Swamp. You'll see why. And we're going to attempt to play it for you. Thank you. So we're going to, in the first half. Oh, Michael, I think you're, no, are you still here? Okay, we'll just play with you. Okay, fine. Okay, so back in the beginning of the set, about 17 hours ago, we played an Ornette Coleman tune called Blues Connotation. And this is the Blues Connotation reprise.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. This next tune was a song that was given to my dad by a gentleman named Dorje in China. And he recorded it with Michael and Peggy Lee and Chris Gestrin before he passed. And he really loved this song. So we're going to play it for you. Mm-hmm.
Brett Chepik on the guitar.
So we're going to bring another guest up. How's everybody doing? Thank you so much for staying and continuing to be part of this amazing music. And we're going to bring Mr. Bob Lanzetti on guitar up. Woo! This song is a...
Hi, Bob.
Hi. This is a Charles Mingus tune that my dad recorded a couple of different times that he also really loved. It's called Boogie Stop Shuffle. And he really liked to play it, so we're going to play it for you. So this is Boogie Stop Shuffle by Charles Mingus.
Thank you.
Mike Serene. Okay, so I would like to invite anybody who has played tonight to come up on stage. Maybe anybody who hasn't played tonight to come up on stage. Any surviving members of the past 14 hours of music, please join us on stage. I was 23 when this concert started. Yeah, look at that. Huh? All right, it's a veritable who's who of who's who. So, I would like to thank, this is our last piece. It's entitled, sometimes he called it the dragon, sometimes he called it raga, sometimes he called it, hey, let's do that one that goes like that. I'd like to thank Jay Clayton for joining us tonight. I'd like to thank Arnold Hammerschlag. Yeah, we'll just applaud for everybody. What the hell? Michael Blake. Mr. Rindy Eckert. Brigham Krause. Peter Epstein. Brad Shepik. Mike Serene. Owen Howard. Aaron Alexander. Bob Lanzetti. Jane Ira Bloom. Me. Him. Lana and Lola. Suzanne. Doug. Judy. You're welcome. And Colin McKenzie for keeping us all sane-ish. So this is our last song this evening. This is entitled The Dragon. Thank you. very much.
Rindy Eckert, Brigham Krause, Peter Epstein, Brad Shevick, Mike Zareen, Aaron Alexander, Owen Howard, Arnold Hammerschlag, Bob Lanzetti, Jake Clayton, Jenny Nemec, Jen Auer Bloom. Thank you all so very much. Thank you, thank you. Thank you, thank you. Thank you.